referee, the famous United States referee, Arthur McCandy, who's been to this country several times before, and in fact has refereed a Jim Watt Championship before. And the first thing you'll notice is that Arguello, the challenger, is a little taller. He stands 5'9 and a half, he's 2 inches taller than Watt. Watt's fifth defence, Arguello's attempt to win his third world title. Watt, the southpaw, comes out, right fist, right foot forward, with that astonishingly pale skin, the colour of candle wax. Arguello having his 71st professional fight tonight. And this is his 16th world championship fight. He's only ever been beaten once in a world title fight, and that was the first one he ever had, way back in 1974. Watt's 46th fight, and his 6th world title fight. Really very much bigger. In fact, he's a quarter pound lighter. The main concern in the Watt camp, I imagine, will be about the vulnerability of his eyes. He picked up some real damage against Sean O'Grady in his last fight back on November the 1st. Came through that, and Watt, who'll be 33 next month, is a very determined young man indeed when his title is at stake. They'll have to pin him down to the canvas and drag the title out of him, I tell you. Another man too anxious to lead. Watt at one time used to be almost basically a counterpuncher, but he's considerably changed his style in later years. And with it has come this astonishing late career success. A real Indian summer of a career. Judges who are sitting outside the ring, the referee doesn't score tonight, three judges outside the ring, I would imagine, will have put 10-10 on their cards for that opening round. They're fighting this championship in a ring that is just over 19 feet square. In fact, originally the ring from the conference centre just up the road was brought here and installed, but the Arguello camp complained that it was too small. It was in fact 16 feet square, and so last night, working throughout the night, carpenters have added 3 feet all round to this ring. Arguello beginning to look a little livelier, and Watt gives ground behind the southpaw lead. Former WBA featherweight champion, 9 stone. Then the WBC junior lightweight champion, 9 stone 4. Now attempting to win the WBC lightweight title, 9 stone 9. And only a few men in the whole history of boxing have won three world titles at different weights. That is what Arguello is attempting to do. Arguello beginning to jab with some severity. And beginning to move in a slightly higher gear. These two have had one of the friendliest build-ups to any championship fight I can remember. From the moment they met, they seem to have instant respect and admiration for each other. I wouldn't say a friendship developed, but they showed utter respect for each other before this fight. All that now behind them. Making one or two footwork mistakes. Jim Watt, of course, is already on record as saying that he doesn't think the man is too versatile, he's a bit mechanical, and that he thinks he himself, Jim, is the better artist of the two. This is a million-dollar fight. Over £500,000 has been paid to put this fight on, and of that, Jim Watt is going to receive more than £350,000. Far and away the record purse for a British fight. Nine-year-old Arguello, now living in Miami, Florida, the youngest man ever to win the World Featherweight Championship and the tallest, 5'9½". So two rounds completed and nothing very much definite either way. Slightly more aggression from Arguello. Arguello tends to come strongly late in fights. Two of his most important fights, he stopped his man in the 13th round. And he's beginning to get through with rather fast and accurate punching. The right hand of Arguello is beginning to find its way across. And Watt would do well to keep clear of that. Well, we've seen Watt give ground before in championship fights. We've seen him hustled a bit in the early stages, but he's managed to outlast people. But I must say, this one looks, he looks exceptionally strong and big. Arguello. And Watt found a little bit of trouble again inside there. And the reach of Arguello is beginning to tell. Both lefts and rights now finding their way into Watt's face. Round three. There's no doubt now that Arguello is the first man to take the initiative and to establish a little bit of superiority. Is just faintly marked around the eyes, in no way cut, but There's a redness appearing under both eyes. Like a soldier back to the corner. Spent most of the round on retreat, had to take one or two punches both from the left and the right hand in the face, and you can see for yourself, I think, particularly under that right eye, just a few reddish marks. Both these men turned professional in the same year, 1968, and it's interesting that they actually had their first professional fights within 19 days of each other, all those years ago, and it's taken all this time for them to find their way together in a 19-foot ring in London. Bob didn't want to be trapped on the ropes, he was quick to get off from there. And there's certainly a more fluid look and a more confident look about Arguello's boxing at the moment than there is about Watt's. Watt is very much on the defensive. Good right hand from Arguello, and he roughs Jim up. And the normally tidy hair of Watt now is ruffled, tousled. Watt tries the left hand over the top. Originally this fight looked like being staged abroad. Arguello Robles of Mexico bid the $1 million originally, but then found he couldn't find an arena in America for it. And so Harry Levine and Mickey Duff, the London promoters, stepped in and have gone into partnership with Mr. Robles to put it on in London. I don't know if he's got time to say it, what, but every time he moves around this ring, there's a post facing him which says Glasgow on it. This fight is sponsored by the Lafferty Group of Companies from Glasgow. And so the word Glasgow appears on all four ring posts. That's two useful rounds Arguello's had. Always moving forward, always taking the initiative. It's always difficult to judge just how a fighter will fare when he moves up a weight. And of course this man has come up two weights. Actually, when you look at him, the height of him, you wonder how he ever made featherweight. Watt keeping his guard high to ward off those wide right hands coming in. Footwork mixed up again. He is a little clumsy at times. stands still for a moment. The champion has to take one to the head and needs to keep moving. Just reddened slightly around the left and right eye. Difficult to tell just how much strength of punch Arguello will have as a lightweight. What is effective when you're at a lighter weight sometimes doesn't prove half as effective when you move up. Short and crisp. Arguello making his travel further. And Watt clearly has decided to plan a campaign in the early rounds here based on countering on retreat, which is very much his old style. Jabbing away into the face of the challenger. And the pace of the fight increases. Put in some good punches, Watt, in this round. He's boxed very, very well on the retreat. And this crowd sense it. And that is the best round that Watt's had yet. Terry Lawless, the man who transformed the career of Jim Watt. At a time when you might have thought Watt would have thought about retiring, which I'm sure he must have done at one time, he went to Terry Lawless and said, "What can you do for me?" Lawless took him over. And ever since then, the pair of them haven't looked back. It's a really remarkable, romantic story of the boxing ring. Now these two men came together very late in Watt's boxing career and have made a total success of the partnership. So very little between these two as they come out for the sixth. Already a third of the way through the scheduled 50. One thing Watt must try to do here is keep those eyes clear of trouble. Which is very much, of course, why he's doing so much retreating. The last thing he wants is too much close quarter work where eyes do get damaged. Punch out as he goes back. This is what the Americans used to call getting on the old bicycle. Boxing on the retreat. Pedaling away backwards around the ring. So up we come for round seven in this fascinating contest between two very, very good men. The pale figure of Watt advances to the center again to face the swarthy-skinned Nicaraguan, Alexis Arguello. He defended the first title he won, the WBA Featherweight Championship. He defended that four times, then gave it up in 1976, said he would retire, and then almost at once came back and proceeded to win the WBC Junior Lightweight title, and then defended that eight times and gave it up because of weight problems again last year after 2.5 years as champion. And then, of course, last year he beat Cornelius Boza Edwards when Boza Edwards took a fight at short notice in the States against him, and he stopped him. But it's fair to say, I think, that Boza Edwards wasn't at his absolute fittest for that. And since then, of course, Boza Edwards has won the very title that Arguello used to hold. Arguello comes forward, seeking with the right. Arguello blinks a little bit as he comes forward. And over goes the champion for the first time in this fight. Just halfway through the seventh round. So, the first real dramatic sensation. And it's all Arguello's. Now then, can Watt escape further trouble? With just over a minute left of this round, and Arguello now sure to put real pressure on. The seconds in his corner signalling to him furiously to come on in. And Watt is having a job to cover up against this little attack here. Of Arguello. So the action is really flared into action. Watt told not to hit and hold at the same time. And there's quite a little bump coming up at the side of Arguello's left eye. Might just be that he felt that coming up and decided to go into real action with dramatic results. So the seventh round is over, and Arguello had the first big success of this championship fight. You can see the mark near his left eye over on the other side of his face. There's a bump and a graze appeared there, which could give him trouble later in the fight. Now let's have a look and see how Jim Watt was bowled over here. Good left hand, and the following right only just missed him. Eight runs to go, and Arguello in front. But the challenger with a slight problem near his left arm. Extraordinary left hand from Arguello, because it started way back, a long way back, and still Watt didn't see it coming. Some Scottish singing starts up to revive the possibly slightly sagging morale of the champion. Although Watt is always a good man when he's under most pressure. And that little setback might just bring something extra out of him. You never know. Arguello now does not look the friendly sort of chap he did earlier at the weigh-in today. Anything but. By that is he was on the ropes and he's getting caught all too frequently. Right, one downstairs, one up from Arguello. Face of this fight now really heating up. And it's turning very much into the challenger's way. Leading again from the nose, 5 seconds into the ninth round. Clearly Arguello has done some damage there to Watt's nose. From inside as well. But every now and again he's making Arguello scowl as he gets the jab in. And Arguello hasn't got off scot-free either. Scot-free. Left hand not very much in evidence. It's all right jabs. And he seems staggered again by left from Arguello. And again. And the champion now is finding this very, very hard. When he walks forward, Arguello pumps one in. But Watt still comes forward. He's trying to turn the tide against the other man now. He's been retreating for 8 rounds and now he's trying to come forward. And again that long left arm of Arguello snakes out. The reach has played a big part in this so far. Thank you, Jim makes another hurried march back to the corner for repairs to the nose. Arthur McCanty, the referee, has had a quick look at it, but is satisfied that he can continue. And Watt is ready to go, but Arguello isn't. And still the blood trickles from the left nostril of Jim Watt. Said earlier tonight that he felt this fight might go the distance. And what is cut underneath the left eye? That's the first real sign of damage around those eyes, but he's cut on the cheekbone under the left eye. That's not a dangerous place. Damage beginning to appear now in more than one place on the face of the champion. This tall, swarthy man not coming forward quite as much now, you'll notice, as he was, backing off himself now. And what bleeds rather badly from that cut under the eye, but of course it's not running into the eye as it would be if the cut was over the eye. It's not nearly such a dangerous place to have a cut, but it certainly doesn't look very pretty. To my mind, Arguello slowed down considerably. Every time he punches, might just be beginning to feel the brace. This is one of the least effective rounds the challengers have. And it's the 10th, and it's very interesting. Almost as though he's taking a breather. Really stood off and done nothing. And what looks to me is they might have even more trouble with that left eye, because there's a red mark above it. Whether he's got a cut up there or whether it's just the blood from underneath the eye being transferred around it, which I think is the answer, well, certainly Lawless is not working at all over the eye. So I think it's just blood that's being smeared around the eye. Marches out eagerly to get to grips in the 11th with a very marked face. And the right hand of Arguello explores and finds the side of the face of Watt. Really now needs a storming finish. He's a good man over 15 rounds, well used to going the distance. Everything now depends on how strong Arguello is. If he's still strong, then Watt may find trouble. If he is weakening at all, anything could happen. Thank you. right hand didn't look as though he was weakening. Certainly took a breather in the 10th. Close look in the face of what I wouldn't have thought the damage there would justify stopping it at this stage, not by any means. Him with considerable force. It's always the punch that's said to be the one to use against the southpaw. What takes another hardish punch, but still in there, battling away to try to keep this crown that he won so late in life. His fifth defence tonight. And what again makes that hurried walk back to the corner. Lawless is talking to McCanty, the referee. Late stages of this fascinating WBC lightweight championship battle between the champion, the pale Jim Watt from Scotland, and the swarthy-skinned Latin American Alexis Arguello from Nicaragua, a man who now is no longer welcome in his own country and self-exiled to the United States. Arguello sinks one up the midriff of Watt. This always promised to be a good battle between these two. And it's been intriguing all the way, because Watt has tried all sorts of tactics here to overcome this reach disadvantage and protect his eyes. He certainly hasn't got a cut above the eyes, which is a small triumph in itself, but he has been on the floor once from a sweeping left hand. He's flung from way back. Backed up, but for the most part it's been Watt moving backwards around this 19-foot Wembley ring. Thank you. prophecy in the dressing room earlier tonight that this could go the distance. Beginning to look as though it might well come true, although run 13 has twice proved quite lucky for Arguello in title fights. He's won two big fights in the 13th run, both of them against Alfredo Escalera, a former world champion. Last time Watt went 15 rounds was his points win over Howard Davis, the American, in one of his title defences. There's a smear of blood on the right-hand side of Watt's head. I don't know quite... I think it's come from the nose and it's been smeared up there. And he's got blood smeared down the left-hand side of his face. I just think it's the blood from his nose and the cut under the left eye that's being transferred around his face. He's beginning to look extremely marked. To do now, there's no more retreating really for him, except when he's under impossible pressure. But as a tactic, it's dead now. He's got to come forward and throw punches. Punch with which to turn the tide. Great black mark now coming up underneath Watt's left eye where they've staunched the flow of blood. But his injury is now beginning to look very, very painful indeed. Well, it doesn't look so bad when Terry Lawless gets the towel to work and wipes the smears of blood away. It's superficial damage for the most part, although one can't quite tell the severity of that cut up under the nose. That's been there a long time, and it's bled all the time. So, just two rounds remaining of this lightweight championship battle in the Wembley Arena, in front of thousands of Scots. Corner, come forward, they're saying to him, come forward, keep punching. Bruising, cutting contest. Always looked like being the hardest title defence Watt had had, and it's proved more than that. Oh, still, Arguello gets the wave on from his corner. And that's finding the punches hard to come by now. He's not raising very many punches in this 14th round. Found one there though, good left hand. Arguello fighting with his mouth open. Obviously feeling the pace of these 14 rounds with 3 minutes still to come. Watt smothered in his own blood again. Bruised all over the face. Mouth and nose bleeding. Gum shield is scarlet. And he takes two hard punches there, but he still tries to keep the right jabbing as he goes back. What a brave man he is. Look at the damage on his face. And McCanty stands at the corner again and watches Lawless towel his man down. The last 3 minutes. Now I wonder what this might bring in this hard battle between two good men, the champion Watt and this challenger Arguello, who's looking tonight for his third world title. All at different weights. And if Watt succeeds tonight, he equals Jimmy Wilde's record of 5 successful world title defenses, which has stood ever since the First World War. Thunderous noise now at Wembley as the Scots stamp their feet and raise their voices. Prediction to me earlier that he thought this would go the full distance will be proved true, and then we shall have to wait for the score of the three judges. Scotland, Jim Watt, who was on the seat of his pants earlier in this fight, who suffered damage to his nose, mouth and around the eyes. He must have been swallowing blood now for something like 7 or 8 rounds. Still in there. Never going to give this title up easily. This one fight alone will have proved him to be a really worthy world champion. Arguello most certainly a very worthy challenger. The seconds now running out, and it's going to go the distance. And Watt makes a very spirited finish to that fight, and they fall into each other's arms in the most sporting possible way.
The judges' scores are as follows. Dick Young scores 147 for Arguello, 137 for Watt.
A massive win for Arguello on the first judges' cards.
Scores 147 for Arguello, 143 for Watt.
Arguello is the new champion.
Judge Albert, 147 for Arguello, 143 for Watt.
It's a unanimous decision, and Alexis Arguello, 29 years old, is the new WBC lightweight champion. Another of those rare men in boxing who have won three world titles at different weights.